I have something to celebrate. A week ago, I officially got my degree. And in order to reward myself for this small achievement, I decided to get a new astro camera. My name's Tim, and welcome back to Astro Addict. The skies are beautifully clear, and this night is actually the fourth night I'm using this camera to get, hopefully, my best image yet of the Heart Nebula. The telescope is standing right back there under the top. You can also see it in the mirror right here. And I planned a little guessing game. I got this new astro camera, but it is not exactly a new product on the market. It was on sale and it was rather a spontaneous purchase. Which means this night I'm going to take you on a tour through the backyard in the telescope and drop some little hints of which type of camera and which model this actually is. So come and join me and find out. I don't often use the tarp, but it was clear two nights ago, one night ago, and this night. And that's why I decided to keep the scope right where it is. What a beauty. I've realized that a lot of people have joined this channel lately, and I also realized that it's been a long time since I properly introduced all of the equipment I'm using tonight. So let's go over all the equipment I'm using tonight, except for the camera, to hopefully get an awesome image of the Heart Nebula in Cassiopeia. My mount is the Skywatcher HEQ5 Pro. For now, I cannot wish for a better mount. It's been with me for almost 5 years now. I did add a small modification, the belt modification, but other than that, this mount is awesome for any amateur or starting out astrophotographer. The main telescope is a small refractor with a focal length of 350 millimeters. It is the Technosky AG70 APO. It is a quadruplet refractor, which means no chromatic aberration at no distortion, well, almost. No distortion at the edges of the image. And this small rig, this small telescope packs a punch. And using it has been so much fun and it's so easy. The thing I probably enjoy the most about this telescope is the focuser. But I still have to refocus. And that's why I'm using an automated focuser. This is the ZWO electronic automatic focuser, the mini version. Using this focuser in combination with this small refractor made this entire rig so much easier to use. I don't have to go outside and refocus when I switch filters, when the temperature drops or when the hours advance. This small thing detects the size of the stars and focuses the telescope better than I could, actually. I've tried it. The guide scope for auto guiding plus the camera are a very pretty combination strapped onto the back of the main telescope just like this. And this whole setup can be moved around so easily. This is just a basic 60 millimeter guide scope with a focal length of, I believe, 240 millimeters and a small monochrome guide camera to have some awesome round stars in the main telescope. All right, we are ready to start. The stars are here. We are almost at deep sky darkness. To get a sense of where we are pointing, I will switch to another filter, to this one. That's polar alignment done. Objects, favorites, my framing of the Heart Nebula. My favorite part of the night. I am also very excited to test this camera on Andromeda Galaxy. Another target that's starting to be in a good position. All right, this seems like the correct orientation. Now let's go into guiding. Setup tonight will be fairly quickly. As soon as the autofocusing is done, I will start the plan. I will take, hopefully, many very long exposed subs on the Heart Nebula. My plan is 10-minute exposures like the previous nights. Multiple 10-minute exposures in sulfur 2 and oxygen 3. With which I can, together with the HA I shot in the earlier nights, create a Hubble palette image. My first Hubble palette actually, which is pretty exciting. I will now finish this setup, turn off the lights and start this night. All right, the telescope is focused and we are slewing to the Hart Nebula again. And it's getting actually a bit cold, too cold for the leather jacket, so I have to go back in soon and maybe get some sleep. The weather these last 3 days has not been beneficial for my sleep. The first exposures are rolling. 10-minute exposures is a lot of risk, actually. If a big satellite or plane goes through them, you wasted 10 minutes of your night, which you could have spent with 10 1-minute exposures or maybe 3-minute exposures, but getting this faint signal on this monochrome camera is really an awesome thing. Right now I'm on the oxygen 3 filter to get some blue into the image. I already have my HA data, which will be mapped to green, which is the strongest signal of them all. And I will again tonight shoot sulfur 2, which will be mapped to red. And hopefully at the end of these 3-4 days, just days of lack of sleep, I will have an image ready of the Hart Nebula in the Hubble palette. I think I dropped enough hints about this camera to tell you what it is. It's a mono camera with an integrated filter wheel, color red. It's a ZWO camera. But which model exactly? It was kind of a lucky find in an online store. This is an ZWO SI 1600 mmGT. Mono camera, integrated filter wheel, and the almost legendary sensor of the 1600 mm. I already have a complete filter set, luminance RGB SHO. Those are the Optolong filters, in case anyone wants to know. And now I will go inside and roll some dice.